In this video, we're going to find the longest chain in alkanes containing multiple substituents. Once we find the longest chain, we'll number it correctly and then we'll name it. These are the three branch alkanes we're going to work with. Feel free to pause the video and figure it out on your own first, and then we'll compare notes when you're ready. If you're new to looking at structures drawn this way, just know that each point represents one carbon with hydrogens. I'll link a video on drawing structures in case you're interested. We're going to start working with the first compound. Since there are multiple substituents, we'll have to first figure out every possibility to find the longest chain. So let's start counting from the left. That gives us a chain with 6 carbon long. It's 6 carbon because we went through 6 points going from the left to the right. Now, instead of counting straight from left to right, if we were to count up, that will give us 7, which is longer than 6. Now let's try, instead of going up, let's try going down. And looks like it's still 7 carbon long. So let's try counting from a different point, which is on the right hand side. And if we go right to down, that will give us 8 carbon, which is longer than what we've counted so far. Now what about if we go up? From up to right, that gives us 6 carbon. And if we were to go from up all the way to the bottom, that will give us actually the longest chain, which is 9 carbon. Now that we've found our longest chain, let's go ahead and number the carbons in the chain. When numbering the carbons in the chain, we want to always start from the end. And in every chain, there are always two ends. In our case, we have one that's on the top and the other one is at the bottom. So let's go ahead and start numbering from the top. And that gives us two substituents. One is at carbon 4 and the other at carbon 5. Since these two substituents contain two carbons, they are called ethyl groups. So we get 4 ethyl and 5 ethyl. Now let's start numbering from the bottom. And if we do that, we get 1 to 9. And now the two substituents are at carbon 5 and carbon 6. So we get 5 ethyl and 6 ethyl. So which numbering set should we go with? Well, we always want to start counting from the end that is closest to the substituent. So in this case, it will be the numbering set on the left-hand side, which is the one in the green. After all, 4-5 is a lower numbering set than 5-6. So the name for this compound is going to be 4,5-diethylnonane. It's nonane because our longest chain has 9 carbons. And we also need to indicate that we have 2 ethyl groups, so therefore we put a di in front of ethyl. Also, we need to indicate where we can find the ethyl group, which is at carbon number 4 and 5. So we place 4, 5, and then hyphen the rest of the name. Now that we're done with the first compound, let's move on to the second compound. What was the longest chain that you counted in this compound? Let's try going through all the possible combinations to see which one is the longest chain that we can find. Since there are quite a few substituents in here, we have a little more possibilities to consider. Looks like the longest chain that we can get from this compound is 7 carbon long. Does that match with yours? Now let's go ahead and number the chain. Numbering from the top is going to give us two substituents, one at carbon 3 and one at carbon 4. Numbering from the bottom, it's going to give us two substituents as well. We get 4 isopropyl and 5 methyl group. So again, we want to start counting from the end that is nearest to the substituent. So in that case, the numbering in green is the one that we're going with because 3 is a lower number than 4. So our compound's name is 4-isopropyl-3-methylheptane. The reason isopropyl comes before methyl is because I comes before M when alphabetizing. This substituent, both of them, are equivalent in terms of priority, so we go in terms of the alphabet. So I comes before M, therefore isopropyl comes before methyl. 4 and 3 are just the location of the substituent, you just put them in front. So that's the name of our second compound. Moving on to the third and final structure, what was the longest chain that you counted in this compound? Well, since there are so many branches in this compound, looks like we're gonna have to consider all the possibilities. And in fact, looks like the longest chain that we can find is 9 carbon. Yep, 9 carbon is the longest chain that we can find in this compound. So now that we found our longest chain, let's move on to numbering the chain. Numbering from the top gives us 3 substituents, ethyl at carbon 4, and sac butyl at carbon 5, and then methyl at carbon 8. We have three substituents in this compound. If we number from the bottom, it's going to give us the same substituent but at different locations. So we have 2 methyl, 5 sac butyl, and 6 ethyl. So which numbering set do you think we should use? Yep, it should be the one on the right, because counting from the bottom is going to give us our first substituent at carbon number 2, whereas counting from the top is going to give our first substituent at carbon number 4. After all, 2, 5, 6 is a lower numbering set compared to 4, 5, 8. Before we move on to naming the entire compound, let's consider the 3 substituents. How are we going to alphabetize this? So we have 5 sac butyl, 6 ethyl, 2 methyl. So let's ignore the number and let's look at the name of the substituent. So we have sac butyl, ethyl, and methyl. When it comes to sac butyl, sac represents secondary. So we ignore that, we just go with the first alphabet that comes after that. So in that case, it will be B. So it will be butyl, B, and then ethyl is E, and then M for methyl. So if we were to alphabetize this, B would come first, and then followed by E, and then followed by M. Make sense? So we place these three substituents together in the correct order, and together with the 9 carbon that we have, which is nonene, this would be the final name for our structure. 5 sac butyl, 6 ethyl, 2 methyl nonene. To recap, the first thing we did when looking for the longest chain was to explore all the possibilities, and then we see which one will give us the longest chain. So we count continuously, and then we see which one will give us the highest number of carbons in that chain. And once we found the longest chain, what we do is we number the chain on both ends, and then we go with the end that is closest to the substituent. And then we alphabetize the substituents if they are in the same priority in order to name the compound. I hope the video was helpful. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.